Hey guys, Darren here from Smart Reselling, and firstly, this isn't going to be a too long a video. It's just going to be mainly updates on what's going out or what's gone out, and also what's coming in. Because I think in my last video I mentioned that I've got some items that I was quite pleased about purchasing. I've still got a few that's arriving. I think about 3 or 4 packages still coming. I'm still negotiating for 2 or 3 lots as well. First of all, stuff that I've sold the True Crime Streets of LA and True Crime Streets of New York game pack for £7.99. That I sent out literally just now. The Hermes guy once again came to pick it up, along with the Only Fools and Horses box set. That went for £9.99. And last night I sold Freelancer, the PC game, for £12.99. That's not actually gone out yet because what I'll do is I'll box that up and I might just do it in normal post. Get the packing slip posted from PayPal. You can do that directly from eBay now or PayPal. Stick it straight on and that will go into the normal post box because it's only a thin game. So I'll do that. And but yeah, I want to show you a few things that I've purchased. First of all, something that I got from Nick Hills, which admittedly is probably most things. I heard him mention the fact that everybody seems to be buying Trivial Pursuit now because of him. And yeah, he's right. You know, I've got Trivial Pursuit out there because of him. But then again, I've also bought that other one that sold. So I've already made money because of him. So, there's a couple of things I want to show you. And these are purely because he mentioned them. Of course, I went on eBay and checked to see what they were selling for anyway, but there's no reason not to trust the evaluations that Nick puts on stuff because he really knows his stuff. So, but what I got, now, unfortunately, I'm going to show you this one first. This one's slightly damaged, but I'll explain something about this in a minute. One of his videos, he mentioned the Tweenies and Teletubbies. I looked around for Teletubby stuff and I couldn't find any that was cheap enough to really make an instant profit on. But I will be, I'll definitely be keeping an eye out. However, this one, the Fizz 20 doll. Now, unfortunately, it's got blue paint on it. Now, I knew about this even before I bought it. But what it is, I paid £5. However, for that money, I also got all the rest. So £5 for all 4. Now on eBay, these can go up to £20, usually about £15-20, maybe even more to be honest, as it's all 4. Now the thing about this one is I figured instead of going, well no, I don't want that because it's damaged. One, it might be emulsion paint. If it's emulsion, it will just come off in the wash. Or it could just be easy cleaned off. If it's not emulsion, I'm not too fussed because I've actually found another one of these, which is currently on its way to me, for £2. So, and that one is pristine. That's perfect condition. So I can easily put the new one that's coming in with the other 3 that I've got, which are Milo, Jake, and Bella, I believe. Don't ask me how I know that. I have no kids. Nick could at least point to the fact that his daughter liked him. I don't have any kids, and yeah, I know him. But yeah, so I figured that even £5 for those 3 was a good deal. The fact that this one comes with it as well. I can easily out this for even a fiver and say, sorry, it's got a bit of paint on it. So that alone would make back the money for all of them. Still, if I can get the paint off, then I'd sell that by itself for about $7.99. $6.99, $7.99. But yeah, I thought great deal. And once again, Nick, if you're watching this video, you can see that your advice is very much getting through to everybody. I would probably have walked past them. I mean, you know, if I saw them in a charity shop, now I would have bought them. But I would never have looked and thought there's money in those. You know, so the soft toy advice was fantastic. I've actually bought a lot more soft toys. Well, I'll go through them when they turn up because I prefer to actually hold them up and show people that I am actually buying this stuff rather than just saying go get this, you know, much like Nick when he held up Fizz, he, you know, he physically had the product. So, but yeah, so that's £5 for all of those. Can't go wrong. I'll make my money back with one. Actually, I'm gonna leave that till last. Next up, the Bill season 1-3. I bought this for £3, and it sells on eBay in its current condition, which is pretty much perfect. I mean, there's a, there isn't a tear. I thought there was a tear, but there isn't. No, it's all good. Maybe just a bit of scuff on the corners, but you expect that. I bought this for £3, and this sells for $19.99 in its current state. So, very good profit there. And these ones here, I'm quite excited about these. I've just got to get these over because there's a lot of them. Okay, right. For £15, this that's what it cost me for 16 of these. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, 16 of them. And basically, it's a whole bunch of now that's what I call music in cassette tape form. There's three there. There is another three there. And three here, three here. Obviously, all different years, all in fantastic condition. I paid £15 for 16. But the main reason was because it had now one, which alone sells for up to £20. The cheapest I've seen it sell on eBay. Realistically, you always get people that just see it as a cassette tape and sell it for a couple of quid. But the average price that this sells for is £16.99 or £17.99. So that single one there would pay for all of these. I've been on eBay. I've seen... I always take the average price. I never take the highest price or the lowest. I'll take the average price. And all of these have been selling quite well in the last month or two. The value wise, there is £96 worth here, and I got on for £15. But that's, as I say, that's the main one. It's in great condition. Looks like it's hardly ever been played or used. Fantastic. So now one, £17 you can get hold of this. Something that you probably see in charity shops, actually. I've seen a couple of these in charity shops a few years ago. Never thought much of it. I just remember thinking, oh, that's an old tape. Now I'm in that mindset of looking for stuff like this, but back then I wasn't. 16 of these for £15. Can't go wrong with that, really. Let's just move these back over here, if you bear with me. I've got one more item to show you, which is, I loved that I found this. As I say, it's a board game. I'm buying a lot more board games now. I've found a couple that are extremely good. I'm waiting for them to contact me back and see if I can actually get it or get them. But this is a brand new sealed Spider-Man Monopoly. You can see, still sealed. I bought this for £3, which I know for a board game is a bit more than usual. Yeah, usually pay 50 pence a pound, but yeah, three pounds. And I don't know if they all come with the six collectible Spider-Man themed tokens, but if they do, then fair enough. But I'm gonna make sure I put that in my ad, because one piece of advice: even if every version of Spider-Man Monopoly comes with those six special tokens that you get inside, even if they all come with it, still mention it, because often you can get more money for the same item that other people have listed just by stating the features that the item has. So if everybody else is listing it as Spider-Man Monopoly sealed, now on I paid £3 on eBay. There's only one that shows up as sold and sealed, and that's £25 it went for. So there's great money to be made in any Monopoly that's a special edition, really, but especially if you can get them sealed as well. Now, I might be a bit cheeky and ask for a bit more. See, because the problem with only one selling that's sealed, all the rest are not sealed. So they've been going for about 18, 20. So the only issue with the fact there's only one sold is there's definitely a market there because a lot have sold in general of these. So you know, people are still after them. But did he undersell at $24.99? Or is that the top range that a sealed one goes for? I'm happy at £25. Don't get me wrong. I only spent three. But he may have undersold. So I might be a bit cheeky and perhaps list it at $34.99. I'll see if anybody else is listing... a sealed version and see what kind of price range they're going, because I don't want to list it for $34.99 if a guy who's done a good job is currently selling another one at $24. I'll just sell this at $24 as well otherwise, but yeah, so that was a great deal. £3, try and not get the light, there we go. Yeah, so £3 for that one, £3 for the bill, £15 for the now job lot, and £5 for the 20s. So you can't really go wrong with that. I think I have actually spent a total of about £80, £90 this week just on these kind of items, but the difference is I know that I can make the money back and they're currently selling and there's, you know, great margins there. I mean, once I've sold all these, I'm probably looking at, I don't know, 40, 60, maybe about £150, £140, £150 once fees and that are taken out as well. But so I'm looking at about £150 worth of stuff here. But bear in mind the tapes go for almost 100 themselves. The bill will be 20, Monopoly 25, Tweenies 15 to 20 for all four. The other fizz that I've bought, the perfect one, the clean one, that's actually coming with a job lot of other soft toys. The lady was selling loads of them, and basically, she was selling it for £2 each. And I think in the end, I managed to get like £7 off. And I said to her, if you just put them all in and I'll take the lot off you, how much, you know, could we do a deal, call it a tenner plus postage, because these are all purchase online, so I had a bit of postage to pay on them all. The nail tapes, I actually had to pay £10 postage, but they came in two boxes. They arrived in two boxes, so I don't mind that. I'll get the postage back either in terms of actual postage charges, or to be honest, the fact that, you know, I can sell this one for £18 and it's basically cost me about 80 pence or 70 pence to buy. I can just put the postage in with it. No, it's not a problem. So so yeah, that's basically what's been going out and what's been coming in. I did have one listing removed, unfortunately, from eBay, and it was the, I don't have them handy, but it was the Maxim Uncovered DVDs. Unfortunately, I got an email saying that eBay considered them as adult material. And unfortunately, they didn't allow it to be sold. Despite the fact that they're happy for people to sell Maxim magazine and FHM and Loaded and Sky, not Playboy. They don't allow Playboy magazine because they see that as an obvious adult publication. So they allowed the sale of Maxim magazine that has the same content in magazine form, but they don't allow the DVDs. So I might bung them on Gumtree. Someone can either come round or I'll bung them in the post, which has kind of put me off something. I don't know if you remember, you know, a couple of videos ago in my second charity shop haul, I showed you a bunch of these figures. This is one of the more tamer ones. There are, you know, there is kind of nudity involved in some of them, and they are basically like anime figures really, and I've got them in a charity shop, and so I'm a bit kind of I'm toying with the idea of whether to put them on eBay or not, in case they get taken off. The last thing I want is to have two strikes against my name or against my account straight away. So I'm tempted to maybe put them on Gumtree, sell them as just one job lot, will post, and just have done with it. You know, I paid very little for these. I can't remember exactly how much now, but I paid very little. So yeah, I might do that, because Gumtree, they don't really care what you sell. It's despite being owned by eBay, but they don't really care. eBay, I don't want to have another one taken off for adult material. If I get a ban or if I get a strike against my name, then all of this becomes worthless for me. So so yeah, I might put them on Gumtree. Amazon, there isn't really any listing for them, so I'd have to pay the membership cost to create my own listing, which I don't really want to do. But yeah, so that was that. What else is there? I just want to say a thank you to Nick for the advice on the 20s. And I also want to thank Sam for his advice on the Warhammer stuff. Fantastic, fantastic information there. I really knew very, very little about Warhammer. I've already told Sam that I used to play the PC game way, way back in the big box edition, which I see now and again sell for like £9-10, something like that still. But yeah, apart from playing the game, I knew nothing about Warhammer. So that was some great advice. I know what to look out for now. And yeah, that's pretty much it for now, I believe. Yeah, that's it. So I'll update you again when more stuff arrives, which hopefully should be this week, so I can make something on the weekend. Expect a couple more Bolo videos on the weekend as well. I plan one on board games. I plan one on soft toys. And if you guys want to see any other categories on ones to look out for, leave them in the comments and I'll see if I can make one up for you on the weekend. But yeah, thank you for watching. And, you know, good luck with all your eBaying. Next time.